So, let's get started. We're in the little hilltop village of Bellegarde-du-Razes, about 30 kilometres from Carcassonne, in the Languedoc in southern France. Hilltop villages consist of circulars or houses built around narrow circular streets on a hilltop. They were built that way around 1,000 years ago for defensive reasons. So here we're heading through the heart of the village. It's about 1,200 feet or 360 metres above sea level. And here we go through La Haute Porte, the high gate. So here we're dropping down out of the village. Quite a steep drop this, and something to look forward to on the way back. There's the village sign on the right. In France, when you see the town name sign, you'll notice there's a red line around it, and that tells you that you're entering a 50 km per hour speed limit. As you leave the town, the sign is black-edged, telling you they're out of the speed limit. It's easy, a lot of people say they don't know when the speed limits apply in France, but it's easy enough, really. Here, we cross what was the old railway track, but which is now for walkers, horse riders and folk on mountain bikes. It seems amazing to think that these tiny villages all had a railway connection once. This around us now was full of sunflowers until recently, and the hillsides are just a mass of vines, horizon to horizon sometimes. The tiny hamlet of Saint-Just is just up there to the left, if you're following this on a map. This is the first steepish hill of the ride. On the left is the lake at La Penne. It's a leisure place, fishing, walking and so on. I videoed a snake taking a swim here a little while ago. On the steepest part of the hill here is a guest house, a table d'hôte called Maison Tranquille. It's a lovely spot for a place. And here's the metropolis of La Penne. Too far to the left to see on camera, but the backdrop is the Pyrenees Mountains. They stretch right across, horizon to horizon. There's a lot of very fancy chickens and turkeys and ducks and other birds who live in this farm here. They stroll around and forage wherever they like, and sometimes they look quite resentful as you pass them, like people do in those bars in small town Utah. Bit of up and down now. This part of Languedoc was populated by Roman soldiers who were rewarded with land here by Caesar when they retired from the Roman army. Now we're approaching Escaillons et Saint-Just de Bellegarde. It takes nearly as long to say the name as it does to cycle through the village, actually. So, round the roadworks and a slightly long downhill stretch back to my village. Get a nice bit of speed up here. There's the sign that tells you that the wine from the winemakers in this area is sold under the appellation Malapert. It means bad stone in Occitan. And it's bad stone because it was sandstone and it was soft and it wore quickly. Now a nice ride up the avenue of plane trees towards the foot of Bellegarde. That's the old station on the right, a holiday place now, I believe. Left up to the village, and here's where I have to make a decision. Take the right for a slow ascent, or the left for a steep one. I usually take the steep one. I guess it must be the masochist in me. Through the hot pot again, and there's the church ahead. Turn right down my street, and we're about 27 minutes. And I'm going to turn into my garage and have a beer. Thanks for watching.